Hello friends, this is Yogesh Murumkar. In this video we will see k-means algorithm. So we are going to see a simple example of k-means algorithm, so that will give us a clear idea what is k-means algorithm and what it is used for. So to start with this k-means algorithm, first of all we will see why k-means algorithm is used. So basically k-means algorithm is used for clustering. Now what do you mean by clustering? Clustering is nothing but grouping the things. So clustering or grouping, you can say. So basic purpose of k-means algorithm is clustering. Clustering is nothing but grouping. For example, there are 60 students. Now you can divide those 60 students into 4 groups by using k-means algorithm. That is the basic purpose of k-means algorithm. Now the best example of k-means algorithm is Amazon. If you go to the Amazon website, you will see different products which are divided into different types of categories. So that is the best example of k-means algorithm. Now, as I told you, k-means algorithm is used for clustering. So basically there are two types of clusters. First one is called as central cluster, and the second one is called as hierarchical cluster. Now again we will discuss the same example. If you go to the Amazon, what you will see is different products are divided into different categories. For example, there is a category called as clothes. So these are the different products, right? They are divided into different categories. So clothes, then this electronic devices is one category. Then there are different products. For example, there are categories for kids, etc. So this is the example of central cluster. Now we will see what is the meaning of hierarchical clustering. So for example, there is one category called as electronic devices. Now there are different products under electronic devices. There can be mobile phones, then there can be laptops, there can be television sets, etc. Now again, what happens in hierarchical clustering, this particular thing can also be divided into For example, a mobile phone can be of Apple company, then there can be mobile phone of Samsung, then there can be Micro Max, like this. And again, this can also be divided into different categories. For example, there can be a Note series of Samsung, then there can be S series, etc. So this is called as hierarchical clustering. Now, the algorithm which we are discussing right now, that is k-means clustering, this algorithm is for central type of clustering. So we will see one example for that. Before that, let us have a look on the steps of k-means algorithm. So these are the steps for k-means algorithm. The first step says that you will have to take a mean value, that is average. Mean is nothing but the average. Then find the nearest number to mean and put it into the cluster. And third step is repeat step 1 and 2 until we get the same mean. Now what is the meaning of all these steps, we will see in a simple example. So let's start with this example, then you will get a clear idea what is k-means algorithm is all about. For example, I have been given a set. Now the set is having these elements 2, 3, 4, 10, like this. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There are total 9 elements. Now I have been asked to divide these particular numbers into, for example, 2 groups. So let us say the value of k is 2. So that I will divide this particular group into 2 groups. This particular set into 2 groups. Now how to do that? Now as we have seen the steps of k-means algorithm, the first step says take mean value. But at the start we do not have any mean value. So what you can do is you can take any random value. So randomly you can take any two mean values, and then we can start with the further steps. For example, one value what I will take is, for example, 4. You can take any value randomly. There is no problem taking any value. So for example, I will take the first mean as this 4, and the second mean value, for example, I will take it as this one, 12. So m1 and m2 I have taken all these two values randomly. M1 is 4 and m2 is 12. Now what second step of k-means algorithm says, find the nearest number to mean and put it in the cluster. So what we have to do is we will have to find out the values which are nearer to 4 and the values which are nearer to 12, and then make the groups accordingly. So first cluster, what I will get is I will put the values which are nearer to 4. I will check whether this 2 is nearer to 4 or 2 is nearer to 12. So how you can check? So what you can do is get the difference. 4 minus 2 is what? 2. And 12 minus 2 is what? 10. So 2 is less than 10. So that means this 2 is nearer to 4. So write down 2 here. Similarly, whether 3 is nearer to 4 or 3 is nearer to 12. Again, 4 minus 3 is 1 and 12 minus 3 is 9. That means this 3 is nearer to 4. So write down 3 here. Again, check for 4. 4 minus 4, that is 0. So obviously 4 is nearer to 4 as compared to 12. So write down 4 here. Similarly, 10. 4 minus 10 or 10 minus 4 is what? 6. And 12 minus 11. So what you will get? 12 minus 10 is 2. And 10 minus 4 is 6. That means 6 is greater than 2. That means that particular value is going to come in the next group. So this 10 is going to come in this particular group, because difference between 10 and 12 is less as compared to difference between 10 and 4. Next value is 11. So obviously 11 is nearer to 12. Similarly, 12 is nearer to 12. 20 is nearer to 12. Then 25 and 30 are also nearer to 12. So obviously the numbers which are greater than 12 are nearer to 12 as compared to 4. So what we got is first cluster as K1 and next cluster as K2. So these are the values. So I will have to complete it here. But we should not stop here. Why? Because what third step is saying, repeat steps 1 and 2 until we get same mean. So we will have to go for the next step also. So what we will do, we will find out the mean value here. So how to find out the mean value? Mean is nothing but average. So M1 I will get as 2 plus 3 plus 4 divided by 3. So here I will get the mean as 9 divided by 3, that is 3. And again M2, addition of all these is 108 and divided by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 108 divided by 6. So what I got is 18. So values of M1 and M2 I have got as 3 and 18 respectively. So the value of M1 is 3 and the value of M2 is 18. Again, find out the nearest values to these two means. So again, I will have to find out what is K1 and what is K2. So let's start. Now check whether 2 is nearer to 3 or 2 is nearer to 18. So obviously 2 will come here, because 2 is nearer to 3. Again, 3 is nearer to 3, 4 is nearer to 4. Now 3 minus 10 or 10 minus 3 is 7 and 18 minus 10 is 8. So this 10 is nearer to 3, because difference between 10 and 3 is of 7 and 18 and 10 is of 8. So this 10 is going to come here. So this is the first group which I got. Now in the next group, these numbers are going to come: 11, 12, 20. So I can directly write down, because what you need to do is just take the difference between these values and this value and compare whether this one is greater or this one is greater. So I have got two groups like this. After that, what we should do is again go for mean, because this is not the mean values which you got earlier. We should get same mean values according to third step. Till then we will have to continue. So I will find out the mean. So 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 10, that is nothing but so the first mean, which is I am so 2 plus 3 is 5, 5 plus 4 is 9, so it is going to be 19 divided by 4. So this is nothing but 4.75. similarly, mean to which we will get is addition of all these divided by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is going to come as 19.6. So first mean is 4.75 and the next mean is 19.6. But for making the calculations easy, what you can do is you can approximate it to 5 and this one you can approximate it to 20. So that it will be easy for us to get or to do the calculations. Again, this mean and this mean, this mean and this mean, they are not same. So what you will have to do is you will have to again find out for the clusters, find the clusters. So again I will find the cluster. So K1, so 5 and 20, these are the two mean values. So we check whether this 2 is nearer to 5 or 2 is nearer to 20. So obviously 2 is nearer to 5, so it is going to come into first cluster. 3 is also nearer to 5, 4 nearer to 5, 10 nearer to 5, again 11 nearer to 5, and 5 minus 12 or 12 minus 5 is 7, but 12 minus or 20 minus 12 is 8. So this 12 is also going to come in the first group. So this is what I got, first cluster. Now what is the second cluster? So K2. So K2 is going to be like this. It will be having 20, 25 and 30. So these two groups, I have got. Now again find out the mean. So M1, if we try to calculate this, M1 I will get it as 7. I have already calculated, I have already done the calculations. So M1 I will get is 7, and M2 that I will get is, the value of this is 25. Again this and this they are not same. So what I will have to do is I will have to go for next step. So M1 and M2. So now the value of M1 is 7 and the value of M2 which we got is 25. So these are the two mean values which we have got, 7 and 25. So again try to find out the clusters. So 2 is nearer to 7 or 2 is nearer to 25. So if you do it like this, I am going to get the clusters like this, 2, 3, then 4, then 10, then 11 and then 12. So this is the first cluster, and the second cluster which I get is like this. K2 is equal to 20, 25, 11, 30. So if you can check, what you can notice is we are getting the same cluster, 2, 3, 4, 10, 11, 12, 2, 3, 4, 10, 11, 12, and 20, 25, 30, 20, 25, 30. So obviously we will get the same means also. So if you try to calculate the mean here, we will get mean as 7. And here we will get mean as 25. That means we got the same mean values to the earlier step. So here you can stop and you can say that finally you have got two groups like this. So the first group which you got is this one, and the next group which you got is this one. So finally what we have done according to K-means algorithm is we have divided these elements into two groups. So this is the first group K1 and this is the second group K2. So the first group is having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 elements, and then the second group is having 1, 2, 3, 3 elements, total 9 elements were there. So this is how you can apply K-means algorithm for clustering. So this is all about K-means algorithm. Thank you for watching. Please do subscribe for similar videos of this kind. Thank you very much.